We use machinery and equipment. Use is very low. So Brother Freak and Africa Coffee Academy, with support of UCDA, came up with an annual coffee technology expo, principally to bring innovation and technology to the producers, processors, and exporters. How can we quickly increase productivity, increase quality through technology? So every year, we have this expo for farmers, processors, and exporters to come and look at new technology, but also to come and listen to manufacturers of the ways of this new technology is working to improve both quality and productivity. So this is the second one we are holding, and we have people from Brazil and Kenya who are explaining how we can improve our quality and productivity through technology. And we have farmers all over Uganda, as you can see, to listen in. We have processors, we have exporters who have come to listen in and also to view the technology. But what is also key in this year is we have financing. You can't talk about acquiring technology without money. So UCDA is partnering with UDB to support coffee farmer groups, coffee processing plants, and coffee exporters to access low interest funds to acquire this necessary technology to improve our quality and productivity. Because they have been tested with smallholder farmers. The one like for if you are washing coffee, say in Kasese, the equipment we are getting now uses much less water, unlike the ones that are on the market that have been on, where you need gallons and gallons of water. Water is becoming scarce, but we need washed coffee for Arabica coffee growers and some Robusta.
There are two key areas that we have brought. We have the zero water pulping solution, pulping coffee without using water. This is the first of its kind all over the world. And this machine was launched last year, and one or two units are being installed in the country, as I speak now. The other technology that, it's an old technology, that but it's being improved right now, is what we call bed dryers, okay, with tipping solution. So I know we have, as a country, we have a challenge on drying of coffee, and sometimes during the picking season, it's rainy season, so we have brought on, this technology, we call it bed dryers. So the farmers, the processors have now new solutions on, to help them with some of the challenges on drying and processing of coffee.
This new technology uses very little water. That's wonderful for the farmer groups. And we are encouraging people to work through farmer groups because that delivers leverage and aggregation of resources. When you are talking about achieving 25 million bags actually, now 2030, it's important that the farmer maximizes the revenue they get from coffee farming. So technology, how does technology help that? If they are going to process their coffee, washing their coffee, wet processing their coffee, they need the modern technology, which is uses less water, deliver better quality, they get more money. When they get more money from the coffee they produce, they will invest more in the coffee. But if they are getting little money, they will have less to invest in, and we shall take longer to achieve our vision. So with improved quality means improved earnings, because with improved quality you get a premium. This season, which is ending, where we are moving from 3.6 million bags to about 4.3 this season. UCDA intervened and told producers and processors, you won't process until we have said you start. This allowed farmers to pick ripe coffee, allowed the farmers to dry their coffee, because they didn't have to process wet coffee, because the processing plants had been closed by UCDA. And we have seen better quality. And for the first time, I think, of course, the volume has increased, but we are going to bring in over $700 million US dollars from $400,000 US dollars just by that intervention in terms of having the right quality. So in the new roadmap, UCDA and private sector, we are saying, let us just go to a turn through increased productivity, access to finance, inputs, and just double our productivity. We shall immediately go to 8 million bags. You know, not even trying to get to 2 tons, where Brazil does 2 tons per hectare, 2.5, Vietnam 3 tons. They feed their soil with a lot of inputs. But just even doing organic fertilizers, mulching, good husbandry, renovation and rehabilitation, we can double our tonnage. And we are seeing these efforts gathering pace because we are seeing the production going up without necessarily increasing acreage. So that's where we are. We need to start with you, young generation. Start a generation of coffee drinkers. So you have to have a culture. Like we have a culture of eating matoke. We eat it in sweet potatoes, sweet bananas. We eat it when it's roasted, when it's the katogo. You know, it's a culture. Now we need to start that culture from schools, from young people taking coffee. And UCDA has a very, very good, big program of domestic coffee consumption they are promoting. That's the only way we can uplift coffee drinking.